Praise and worship. Awesome. Praise and worship. Every praise. Every praise.
Thank you. not studying the Bible study. We are studying the book of Revelation. We are studying chapters 2 through 3, this one said, at 6 p.m. Please join us for this revealing story. Prayer focus for this week is James 1 to 3. Consider it pure joy, my brothers and sisters, whenever you face trials of many kinds, because you know that the testing of your faith produces perseverance. Arthur,
Altar flowers,
the beautiful flowers that adorn the altar are from the church council for today's anniversary Sunday. Remember, if you or your ministry would like to donate flowers for the altar, please sign up in the North Act. Flowers deliveries must be made on Friday between the hours of 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. We are also looking for teachers for Children's Church. Ages for Children's Church are 4 to 17 years. Last week, we have 14 children. Thank you, Alfredo and Dana. The 32nd Laity Awards Lunchathon is on October 28th. The cost is $65. You may purchase your tickets now so we can reserve tables. The order forms are on the table in the North Assembly and put on the administrative assistance desk in the office. The 2023 Mapleport Laity honorees are Marilyn Patton Gross and Bruce Kennedy. Church Conference. Mark your calendar. Church Conference is scheduled for Sunday, November 19, 2023, at the church at SPRC. We'll meet at 2 p.m. Congregants will meet at 2:30 p.m. in the fellowship hall. Email all reports to the church at mapleparkumc@wahoo.com. An anniversary gift envelope is in your bulletin. You will have until the end of the year to give your love offering of $60 or more for adults, $10 for youth, and $5 for children. Anyone has body damage from the rains, call FEMA at 312-841-6627. Our announcee, Hardeman Jr. There is also no birthdays and anniversaries at this time. Is there any visitors in the house today?
Any visitors? We love that you joined us today, and if you are able, please tell us your name and where you're from, and the ushers will give you guys a special gift. Thank you guys for coming to visit us today.
Amen.
I'm Drew.
y'all a really groovy song. So welcome, y'all.
Thank you.
going to do, Peggy actually and some other girls did this dance when they were little. So the boys are going to do it in their version, which is also awesome. This group, Peggy named these boys after her Uncle Terrence, so they're called the T-Bones, T-Birds at the school. So these are the T-Bones, T-Birds, in honor of Terrence. Enjoy the dance. God, I hope you guys are blessed.
Prayer concern list in front of me. And before before I pray, I just want to say to Sharon Ashley, and Genevieve Ryan, Mary Davis, Aaron Fleming, Amelia Gibson, Bobby Henry, Ellie Hester, May Jester, Helen Johnson, Lois Johnson, Carolyn Lovelace, Michelle McDaniels, the McMahon family, Thelma Robinson, Ryan Massilli, Simba Gray family, Jerise Shaw, Eric Shingles, Wanda Smith, Renard Sutton, Harold Williams, Carla Williams, Gloria Williams, Wendy Watkins, and all those who things I know I'm not on this list. Be encouraged. Our Father knows what you need, and I want you to trust His provisions for your life. As you come to the altar, please remember our brothers and sisters. Say a prayer for them. The altar is open. And I want to say this too for those who are at the altar. Your prayer may be longer than my prayer, so when I'm done, please don't feel that you need to get up and go to your seat. You stay here as long as you need to. And for those of you who are done, and you send your peace to God, please feel free to return to your seats. For those who made an altar at your seat, you take as long as you need. We serve a God who is ready, willing, and able to hear our prayers and to answer them. Heavenly Father, good and gracious God, you are so awesome. And we thank you for being the awesome God that you are. Thank you for loving us. Thank you for providing for us. Thank you for the way you take care of us. Thank you for protecting us. Thank you for mending broken hearts, bereaved hearts. Thank you for the way you have blessed marriages for those who are celebrating anniversary after anniversary after anniversary. Thank you for birthdays, for those you have blessed to see another year. Thank you for this church, which has become a home to so many. Thank you for this church, which provides just a life for this community. Thank you for the brothers and sisters who have served here for so many years. Thank you that it is a place where people can come when the weight of the world has fallen on them. Thank you for our young people, for giving them a church where they can just be themselves, a place where they can come and make mistakes and still be loved and be accepted. And Father, now we want to ask for your forgiveness. Forgive us for not spending time with you this week. Forgive us for our shortcomings. Forgive us for when we have grumbled and complained instead of thanking you. Forgive us for our sins. Forgive us for being disobedient. Forgive us for not loving one another the way you have called for us to love each other. Forgive us for not being good neighbors. And Father, now I just ask for you to hear the prayers of my brothers and my sisters. Bless our pastor. Bless our first lady and your children. Father, I ask that you call people to leadership. Bring more leaders into our church, Father, to our city, to our communities, Father, that they will guide us to your perfect will. Father, I pray that you will bless those on our sick and shut-in list, Father. You will heal their bodies. I pray for their caregivers, Father. For children who are taking care of their sick parents, Father, please encourage them. Lift their heavy hearts, Father. Father, our church ministry, our choir ministry, Father. Thank you for uniting women in faith, Father, who came together to pamper women yesterday, Father. You know, sometimes it's hard to be a woman. It's even harder to be a black woman. And Father, I'm so glad you allow us and you use us and this church home to be a blessing to so many women yesterday who came out. We thank you for those who gave up their time, their energy, their resources, and their talents to help make that a successful day. Father, we are so grateful. And I ask that you have mercy on us. Have mercy, Father. Have mercy. Have mercy. Father, as I close my prayer, I just want to say thank you. I am so grateful. I am grateful, grateful, grateful.
They were furious and wanted to put them to death. But a Pharisee named A teacher of the law who was honored by all the people stood up in the Sanhedrin and ordered that the man be put outside for a little while. Then he addressed that the Sanhedrin man of Israel, consider carefully what you intend to do. Judas and Galen appeared in the days of the census and led a band of people in the boat. He was too cute and all his followers were scattered. Therefore, in the present case, I advise you, leave these men alone, let them go. For if their purpose or activity is a human organ, it will fail. But if it is from God, you will not be able to stop those men. You only find yourself fighting against God. The word of God. For the people of God, you may be seated.
Amen.
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 gonna say it again. How we got over. Standing tall, standing strong is our theme. Happy anniversary. Not just any anniversary, but 60th year diamond anniversary. Maple Park. Come on, let's celebrate.
Yeah.
Not only in this church life, but in your life, he Lord. I want to pick up this text from a rebuttal of Peter. I want to bring you to the prison break and understanding why what God had to do in this situation is so important. Not only in this text, but in your life. Ain't nobody stopping us now. It's one of them songs I know that everybody has danced to at their party. Matter of fact, when you get into your car today, trust me, you're going to turn it on. You're going to find it on YouTube. Ain't no. Now, we're on. Or keep it. They were being put in Amen. Just read your word. It's not by your traditions. It's not by what you think. Jesus came so that you and everybody else who's willing to receive him by faith can have everlasting life. And not have just any kind of life, but have life and have it more abundantly. And remove any doubt, remove any guilt, remove any shame, remove any thought that I'm not good enough, that I don't love enough, that I'm not of God enough. I am the righteousness of God and not of myself. Pastor, why are you getting so excited? Because this is the reason why Peter and the apostles fought so hard. This message didn't need to go out. This message had to go out. When they threw them in jail to try to silence them because the people were following them and they were getting excited about this teaching of the way, they said that we must do something about this or it's going to destroy our tradition. They threw them in jail. And God sent his angel and brought them right out of jail. Peter and the apostle, I want you to say with me because I'm paraphrasing this thing. Peter and the apostle went right back in the streets and start preaching this gospel of the good news that brings sight to the blind right back on the street corner.
Yes, hallelujah.
Are you hearing what I'm saying to you this morning? They threatened to stone them to death. Just like most people threaten to stone you to death because of what you believe and not what you conform to.
Yes.
Peter said to the high priest and all of those that was in a committee in verse 29, Peter and the other apostles replied, "We must obey God rather than man." I'm going to say this again. We must obey God rather than man. The God of our fathers raised Jesus from the dead, whom you have killed by hanging him on a tree. God exalted him to his own right hand and prince and savior that he may give repentance and forgiveness of sin to Israel. They go on and say, we have our witnesses of these things, and so is the Holy Spirit whom God has given to those who obey him.
Yes.
Essentially what Peter is saying to them, I don't care what your threats are.
Come on.
I don't care what your words are to close us down, to shut us down, to not have us to do what it is that God called us to do. We will not stop. Stopping us now.
All right.
It's an understanding that when you walk with God, when you talk with God, when you believe what God has said to you in your spirit, there will be people that come up against you in places that you thought would never rise up against you. Many times the places where people rise up against you, you think that they should be standing with you, but they will. been told that you will never have what it is that God told you in your spirit.
Yeah.
But the devil is a lie.
Yeah.
You have to stand just like the apostle said and say, we can't be worried about what you're going to do to me. What you do to me will never amount to what God will do to me if I don't bring forth what he said. You're standing, Maple Park, because you understand there's more to this story. There's more to this story. As they begin to say, we're going to stone them to death, I want you to pay attention to what a wise spirit said to these high priests. When they heard of this, they were furious and wanted to put them to death. But as Satan, I decided that I had to look up and laugh. But one of these fellow Christian brothers,
yeah.
One of your church members, it wasn't nothing, it wasn't. A Pharisee named Gamaliel, a teacher of the law, who was honored by all. Stood up and said, in order that he just didn't say, in order that the men be put aside for a little while. Then he addressed the men in the chambers. Men of Israel, consider carefully what your intent, what you intend to do with these men. This is good right here.
Yeah.
This is good right here. 36 begins. Some time ago, Thaddeus appeared, claiming to be somebody, and about 400 men rallied with him. He was killed.
My Lord.
And all his followers were dispersed, and all came to nothing. After him, Judas, a appeared in the day of Cephas and led a band of people in revolt. He too was killed, and all his followers were scattered. I want you to understand that, and I don't want to read this. Therefore, in the present case, in this case, because we see what happened in that case, but in this present case, I want you to get this. Therefore, in this present case, I advise you to leave these men alone.
Yeah.
Let them go. Listen, for if their purpose of activity is of human origin, it will fail.
Yes. Yes. Yeah.
You didn't get it because you're not shy. I advise you to leave these men alone.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I'm preaching to somebody this morning.
Let them go.
For if their purpose or activity is of human origin,
yeah,
it will fail.
Come on.
But the
You to do it.
I know without a shadow of a doubt, and this is not arrogance, this is all but spirit. I know God would have called me to this church at this time if this is not a move from God. It's uncomfortable. It's uncomfortable and it's unusual because I'm not trying to get in your business.
Come on, Pastor.
I don't get upset when you don't invite me to places. In my spirit, it wasn't meant for me to come. You thought that you were trying to keep me out. But you can't keep out what God is going to do. Some of them, This is getting ready to get real crazy. Am I saying that time? Y'all got 5 minutes. I'm gonna wrap it up in 5 minutes. I promise you, we're gonna be out of here at the chicken shack at 12:45. I promise you. Listen, he said, he said this. He said, this is gonna really shock you. Do you know that you could be in a church house doing church business? And you and your crew can get completely wiped out.
Yes.
Because you're not doing it for God.
Right.
You're doing it for yourself. Your reputation to your people that you know that's connected to this church. You got to make it glorified so that you can get the glory. Thinking that you're doing it so that God can get the glory. If it's of God, you don't care how ugly it looks. As long as you know you're doing it so people will get liberated by what you're doing. And the way that you know people will get liberated by the things that you do is by you doing it in love. Church. it will come to nothing. But if it's of God, it will stand. Ain't nobody stopping.
Come on, God.
You are the ruler. You are the ruler. You are the ruler. In this season, it's time to go higher.
Amen. Yes, it is.
Amen.
It's time to go higher.
Yes, yes, yes.
Don't worry about who's attacking you. Don't worry about what's coming against you. It won't stand.
Yes.
I want you to stand out this time. Let the church say amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
And amen.
Amen.
Now give God the best praise. Is an opportunity for those that are online and those that are in the church to give your life to Christ. Listen, I say this all the time. Salvation starts first by repenting to say, yes, I'm a sinner. Lord, forgive me for all that I have done. The second part is that invitation that you invite Christ into your heart. That not by the good works you do, it's not by works at all that you're saved. But by God's grace and the faith that you have in what God has done and the life that the resurrection of Christ Jesus. The third thing you do is out of your mouth say, Lord. Say, God, Jesus, I want you to be my Lord and Savior. That means that there is nothing over you, and I'm giving myself to you. Repent of your sin, invite Him in your heart, and make Him your Lord and Savior. I offer Christ to you, my brothers and sisters, right now. Is there one today?
Come on,
let's give God a praise.
Oh, God.
through Christ. Bishop over there going in on that piano. And she got up in the spirit. That's what I'm talking about. If you're going to do it in excellence, don't do it at all. Amen. Now, this is our responsibility. We have a responsibility now. That we now have to begin to raise, begin to stand, begin to encourage those now in Christ Jesus, our brothers and sisters. It's not time to say, oh, thank God they're joining us at Naval Park. But now to say that what do we now need to do to make sure that they're fully enclosed in an understanding of who God is. Amen. I didn't get around to say this part. Maple Park would love to be your church. And I would love to be your pastor. Worship committee. Did I get it right this Sunday? I love my worship team.
You got it.
I love it. I'm serious. I want that love direction. Amen. Who do we have?
Pastor, before the secretary comes, this is God. This is of God. We just talked about this.
Yeah.
We had Iris who came, and she brought her grandma.
Yes.
Got a lovely lady here, and she brought us a significant other.
Good morning, church.
I
introduced
Rhonda
Elliott,
Chanel, and Will
Brewer.
Rhonda, Chanel, and Will.
To God be the glory. To God be the glory. Listen, Bob, when we exit today, I want to sit down and I want to talk with you guys for a moment. Amen.
Amen.
You're excited?
Yeah.
I know y'all, when you open your voice and say, that's my grandson, and them tears start flowing. You said, I ain't gonna let him get his without me getting mine. That's right. Ain't that right? Amen. And my brother, you ready? You ready? You got this. You know that, right? To God be the glory. Man, we need to come on and rally around this young brother. We need to stand with this brother and be with him. Come on, man. Come on up here. Drew, come on. Y'all give his brother some love.
Amen.
Yes, indeed. Amen.
Amen.
Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. Amen. Amen. So these your brothers in Christ.
Yes.
Amen. You go to these men where there's a need of wisdom. Understand.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
There's a special place in my heart for the brothers. Amen.
Yeah.
Y'all ladies, y'all always got sisters. And sisters on top of sisters. And girls on top of girls.
All right.
We gotta surround our young kings with kings, other kings.
Yeah. Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
To bring forth fully what God has in store, man. Amen.
Amen.
Y'all give God a praise and let's move forward. Amen. Y'all, I'm telling you, we're going to be out of here. We're not going to rush it, but I'm telling you, we got a blessing of baptism today. Amen.
Yes.
Amen. Y'all feeling good?
Yes.
Y'all excited? Amen. Come on, who's bringing for? We got the $1 million. Y'all want me to do it? Oh, okay. There you go. I'm about to say, y'all. Go. Boy, look at that. Boy, I'm cold blooded.
Good afternoon, church.
Good afternoon.
And happy 60th anniversary. 60 years means that we started in 1963. I've been here since, I think, 1965. I'm not sure. 65 or 66. But throughout those years, I've seen so many ministries in this church. I've participated in so many ministries. Brother was helping coach the basketball team. We had a basketball team. We had cheerleaders, a youth ministry, young adult ministry. And I did participate in the community garden and the food pantry. The food pantry is brand new, thank God. So God is just doing things in this church. But I was so touched today when I saw the youth participate in the service. Because it reminded me of when I was growing up in the church. When I had to get up and recite some poem or participate in the Easter play and get in front of people and forget my lines. But to do that with the encouragement of the people here, it's so good to be able to experience those things with family. And so when you do mess up, to not be ridiculed, but instead be encouraged. This is the place for it to happen. And then to see Peg's dance group perform today. Another one of our own who grew up in this church, who participated as a child as a liturgical dancer, and then went on to start teaching the students that were here, including my kids, and then to start our own national award-winning dance group.
Amen.
So make a pause. God is using this church in so many ways. But in order to continue to do these things, we need help from you all. We need you to continue with your generous giving and contributions. So today, we have two offerings. We have the regular tithes and offerings in the big baskets, and then for the smaller baskets, the offering is for the building fund, which goes for the maintenance of this building, including fixing that elevator. And also today, we have envelopes in your bulletins for the anniversary. And we also have a QR code, so if you didn't bring your checkbook or you didn't bring any money, you can still give using this QR code here. So we try to make it convenient for you. And for those worshiping online, there's a QR code on the screen that you should also use. You can also mail your check to Maple Park United Methodist Church at 11705 South Elizabeth. I have a scripture for you on my phone. It comes from 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 7. And it says, each of you should give what you have decided in your heart to give, not reluctantly or under compulsion, but for God loves a cheerful gift. Yes. Usher, please say, Charles.
Oh, no.
Father, we just thank you for this day. We thank you for this opportunity to celebrate 60 years of ministry that you have allowed through this church. We pray that you would bless these offerings that have been presented before us, Lord God, for the upbuilding of your kingdom, that you would multiply them to save lives and to bless more families. These things we ask in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. You may be seated now in service of baptism. If you have a question, please take out your mouth at the center. If you have it, we'll know.
Open to people of all ages, nation, as well as races. If so, say I do.
I do.
Will you nurture these children and these youth in Christ's holy church, that by your teaching and example, they may be guided to accept God's grace for themselves, to profess their faith openly, and to lead in a Christian life. And so say I will. Amen. Now the congregation, we are at part 8. This is on page 40. This is your response. Church, to you, as Christ's body, the church, we affirm both your rejection of sin and your commitment to Christ. If so, say we do.
We do.
Will you nurture one another in Christian faith and life, and include these persons now before you in your care? Let's read.
With God's help, we will.
graces worked. The Holy Spirit worked within you. That being born through water and the Spirit, you may be a faithful disciple of Jesus Christ. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Come on, my man. spending time with him, calling him. Amen.
Amen.
But as you know, this is just the beginning.
Amen.
Amen. Church, I charge you, whatever resources, whatever we need to do, to make sure that the youth ministry of this church grow. Not only in numbers, but in spirit and in truth. Let's do whatever needs to be done. Without them, there is no us. Without them, there is no us. Encourage their laughter. As you grow them, they will learn when and when not to laugh. Laugh with them right now. They don't understand, but soon they will. My three brothers and sisters in Christ, was the water and the baptism, was that what saved you?
No.
What saved you?
Believing in God.
Believing in God.
Amen.
And God's mighty hand. That's what we talked about. Amen. Amen. We don't go home. Y'all ready to go home? But before, I want to be obedient to those. Over on this side, come on with me. I want you to remember your baptism on this day. And I sent it. I want us to remember your baptism.
future, I'm going to ask the choir to stand right here. I'm going to ask persons that's on this side to come up and to stand right in front of the altar there, and persons on this side to stand. I'm going to ask for our baptism folks to stand right here with the pastor and our new
so far. We got it. Yeah, more
oh,
room.
That's great. Okay. Oh, that looks wonderful, y'all. That looks really good. All right. Hey, Deborah, I need you right up there on the second row, right on here, right here on the second row. Oh, yeah, that looks really good. Yeah. Dana. Kathy, you come in right here. Dana, you go over here. Dana on the other side, right here with Ethel. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay. All right, can I get everybody face me? Hello, can I get everybody to look at me so I can make sure? Miss Viv, yeah, there you go. You looking the other way. I need to make sure I can see everybody's face and nobody's blocked. Okay. Where you going, Pam? Oh. Right here next to Mr. Hope. Right here. Right there.
Right here.
Yeah, I can see perfect. Right there. Yeah, yeah.
Is this my good side,
Greg? Yeah, that's a good side. Okay. All right, everybody look at the camera. You got a regular camera? You taking pictures with that?
Yeah. I got it.
Okay.
Phone camera.
Oh, what's with this?
I'm not sure about that.
Okay, yes. Yeah. Well, I'm already videotaping, so.
Just give me a little bit of this.
Yeah.
Something about this, man. I just.
Okay.
It looks too dark.
Oh, that's pretty.
So, yeah, it looks really good.
It looks too dark, yeah.
Yeah. My camera, my phone don't take good camera. Yeah, I ain't got no iPhone. I'm an Android. I don't have no iPhone.
I trust this better.
Yeah, I'm just gonna take this.
We're gonna say so because it's all together. All three of you.
Yeah.
One.
Okay.
Two.
All three of you said Jesus. That's right. Come on.
I got it.
One more time.
Yeah, right.
I'm snapping.
Here we go. One, two, three.
Jesus!
Great. Bishop, is that good enough?
Good.